Hey there, Lisette here for Tool Tester. Are you interested in trying out MailerLite? If so, this tutorial is for you. We'll guide you through the process of setting up your MailerLite account and show you how to create stunning email campaigns. Now, whether you're a business owner, blogger, or other creative professional, MailerLite has everything you need to engage your audience. So let's dive in and get started with setting up your MailerLite account. To set up a MailerLite account, you can click on the link we've included in the description. Once you're on the MailerLite homepage, click on the Sign Up button at the top right-hand corner. From here, you'll be redirected to the Sign Up page where you'll be given the choice between signing up with your email address or through your Google or Microsoft account. For this tutorial, we'll choose the email sign up option. Once you've entered your company name, full name, email address, and password, click on the Create My Account button. You'll then receive a verification email in your inbox. Once you've clicked on the verification link, you'll be taken back to the website where you can complete your profile by providing your website URL. If you don't have a website, you'll be asked to enter your social pages or alternatively, explain why you don't have a website. This is all part of MailerLite's terms and conditions to ensure that your business complies with its rules. Now, depending on what information you choose to enter, you'll need to complete a few more steps, including your company address and the features that interest you. You can individually choose from campaigns, forms, websites, automation, transactional emails, or you can select all if relevant. Once you've completed the step, you'll be taken to the MailerLite dashboard, where you'll manage your email campaigns, subscribers, and more. This interface is extremely user-friendly. In terms of plans and pricing, you'll automatically be signed up to MailerLite's Forever Free plan, so there's no need for any credit card details at this point. What's more, to help you get a feel for all of the different features on offer, you'll also have access to their advanced features for 30 days, all for free. Now, after this 30-day trial is over, your account features will become limited and revert back to the Forever Free plan unless you upgrade to a paid plan. We've linked their pricing plan in our description. Now that you have completed the initial setup of your account, one of the first things you'll want to do is create a subscriber group to organize your contacts. Head over to the Subscribers tab in the top menu, then to Groups. Now choose a group name that will clearly differentiate these users from others, for example, Customers. Then, once you've chosen your group name, head back to All Subscribers and click the Add Subscribers button in the top right-hand corner. Here you have the following options. Import from a CSV file, copy and paste from Excel, or add a single subscriber. If you're looking to bulk upload your contacts, we highly recommend doing this in CSV format. You'll need to prepare the file in advance with all the necessary fields such as name, company, and email address. You'll then be asked to match the fields to ensure that your file's data is mapped out correctly. Once you've mapped out your user data, select the list you'd like to upload to and hit Finish Uploading Subscribers. Next, you'll need to click on the group that you created, and from there, you can start assigning your user criteria. You can do this based on the signup date, signup source, location, time zone, and other more advanced settings. How you choose to segment your users all depends on what makes most sense for your specific business. If you'd like some guidance on this, you can check out our blog article about email segmentation. Now let's move on to designing a signup form. By using one, you can capture email addresses and start building an email list directly from your website. Click on the Forms tab in the top menu. Here, you'll see a couple options. The first, to create a pop-up form, which I'm pretty sure we're all familiar with. As the name suggests, this type pops up a new window when a user visits a site and asks them to subscribe by entering their email address and other details. Or, you can create an embedded form, which you insert directly into a landing page or similar. These are usually used for ebooks, webinars, and other lead magnets. For this tutorial, let's choose a pop-up form. You then can choose a name, which, by the way, is only for internal use and can be changed later. Next, you select the user group and your pop-up template. MailerLite has a good selection of free customizable templates. When you're happy with the design of your template, you'll be asked to set your user behavior settings. For example, you can set up a timer that tells the pop-up to appear after a certain time has elapsed, or you can have the pop-up appear at a certain point on the page as the visitor is scrolling. Once you choose, hit Save and Continue. Then you can copy the JavaScript code directly onto your website. Now that your subscriber group and signup form are ready, it's time to create your first email campaign. Click on the Campaigns tab in the top menu, and then go to Create Campaign. Choose the type of campaign you want to create. It can be a regular email, A/B split campaign, auto resend, or RSS campaign. For this video, we'll go with a regular campaign. Choose your campaign name, email subject, sender, and language. Next, it's time for content. Select the template you'd like to use. You can use your own, create a new design, or alternatively, explore the template gallery. MailerLite offers just under 100 email templates. You'll be able to use these during your trial period. However, these are not available on the free plan. Once you select a template, you can unleash your creativity and design your first email campaign. MailerLite's drag-and-drop editor makes it easy to add images, text, buttons, and more. So experiment with different layouts, colors, and fonts until you're happy with the look and feel of your email. Once your campaign is ready, hit Done Editing, and now select the subscriber group you'd like to email, and finally, review your email campaign. You can send a free test preview email to your inbox to ensure everything looks good through the eyes of a user. Once you're happy with everything, hit the Next Schedule button. Here you can choose Send Now or Send Later. And with that, you've completed your first MailerLite email campaign. Thanks for watching our tutorial. We hope you found it useful and that it's helped you get started with MailerLite. You probably have more questions though, so check out the links in the description for more information and feel free to write to us in the comments section. See you soon.